Hey, I'm Manny, I'm here with DRlcore, gonna talk about the science behind SmartWall. Let's talk basement finishing, because traditional methods can be risky. I know that for a fact. Basement building techniques are one of the last frontiers of building science. It has taken a long, long, long time, but the experts now finally agree on how it should be done. As building science has progressed over the years, traditional methods of finishing basement walls have come under attack. The traditional way to renovate a basement is, of course, to use stud framing. Fibrous insulation, polyethylene vapor barrier, and drywall, just like you would above grade. Nothing wrong with that, or is there? The problem with basements is that they can get wet from both the ground around them as well as from interior sources of moisture. Concrete is porous material and moisture can pass through it. Therefore, an unfinished foundation may appear to be dry, but only because moisture passing through the foundation is evaporating into the interior airspace. To illustrate this, a simple test can be done by taping plastic on a material that does not breathe over foundation floor or wall for a minimum of 72 hours. Building science tells us that moisture travels from hot to cold and from wet to dry. Therefore, basement moisture issues are typically more prevalent from late spring until early fall, when the external environment is both warmer and wetter than the internal basement environment. To understand what is happening behind your walls, we will take a closer look at how traditional building materials interact with one another. Have you ever considered why your walls have cold spots? Although this could be caused by a lack of insulation in certain spots on your wall, the more likely culprit at play is a phenomenon called thermal bridging. Thermal bridging occurs when a conductive material such as aluminum, steel, or concrete, wood, provides a path for heat to flow around the insulation. The bypassing or bridging of the less conductive material significantly reduces its effectiveness as an insulator. Thermal bridging is one reason you can't blindly judge insulation based on its stated R value. Over the years, building scientists have shed light on this topic. As a result, changes were made to the 2015 National Building Code of Canada to recognize the effective R values of wall assemblies instead of their nominal R values. Nominal R value only takes into account the thermal resistance of the insulation layer, typically fibrous insulation between wood studs. Effective R value, on the other hand, takes into account the cumulative value of the thermal resistance for the all materials within the assembly. Insulation and polyethylene vapor barriers have a love-hate relationship. On one side, polyethylene vapor barriers are supposed to protect insulation from any sort of moisture intrusions, but on the flip side, should any moisture penetrate the assembly, that vapor barrier will keep the moisture locked in and could cause mold and mildew. Insulating a basement can be safely accomplished if it has been properly assessed, and any known moisture conditions have been dealt with accordingly. If the walls are occasionally damp, but no visible water flow accumulates, then it's normally safe to go ahead and cover the walls. Research shows that in an average home, up to one-third of the heat energy is lost through uninsulated basement walls and slabs. The use of fibrous insulation in a basement environment is okay if it is kept dry and there is no air movement. Unfortunately, this is highly unlikely considering the unique ecosystem in which it is being used. Additionally, fibrous insulation creates air pockets between the foundation and the drywall. It is understood that some level of moisture will be present within the air pockets of the fibrous insulation. Next, we take a look at the vapor barriers. A polyethylene vapor barrier serves as a moisture and an air barrier. Traditionally, the vapor barrier is installed over the top of the insulation and framing, but before the drywall. However, there are simply too many opportunities where a vapor barrier can be compromised, and as such, cannot be guaranteed to 100% protect the insulation from moisture and air intrusions. Fibrous insulation works just fine if it remains dry, and a continuous polyethylene vapor barrier does a great job in stopping moisture movement. It is when the two are combined in a traditionally built wall that problems can begin to arise. If air pockets exist within the assembly, there will always be a chance for water accumulation to occur and for mold and mildew to exist. It is important to keep any moisture-sensitive materials such as wood, paper, and fiberglass batts from coming into direct contact with the concrete foundation wall. DRicore SmartWall has been developed with one goal in mind: to offer the smartest product available for the residential basement finishing, backed by building science. Unlike the rest of your house, the basement sits below ground level and is surrounded by soil that remains cold and wet. When traditionally finishing a basement, this can pose many problems. However, by applying some basic building science to the design process, a basement can be safely finished. That's why choosing the right finishing materials for your basement is a crucial step towards creating a safe and healthy living environment for years to come. SmartWall is a high-performance prefabricated wall panel designed specifically for basement finishing. Taking everything we know about building science, SmartWall has been developed to withstand the unique ecosystem of the basement environment and is used anywhere concrete walls are present. Partition walls can be constructed the traditional way since these walls are not directly affected by the foundation. Why should SmartWall be used in front of concrete? The answer is simple. Concrete is porous material and moisture can pass through it. SmartWall has been designed specifically to deal with these elements. DRicore SmartWall incorporates rigid foam insulation that has been infused with graphite, meaning the cold never meets the warm side of the room, therefore greatly reducing the potential for condensation. SmartWall is a panelized system. Each panel is 23 inches wide and comes in standard 8-foot or 10-foot lengths. Panels can be cut to fit any desired ceiling height or basement layout. When finished, SmartWall will look like every other wall in your home and can be painted to suit your tastes. SmartWall has been tested to the fullest lengths possible and it is backed by the industry's highest standards of approval. SmartWall meets the requirements of the National Building Code of Canada and the International Residential Code in the United States, and it meets my code.